Okay. Now we have to discuss about some questions, which is related with the Indas 33. Please look at the question. Here, ex limited had an after-tax profit of 40 lakh for the year. 80,000 of this was earned from the one-source sale of machinery. In the period, it paid dividend to the ordinary shareholders, rupees 1 lakh, and 5 lakh to preferred shareholders. It had 1 lakh ordinary shares in the issue for the period. Here, you have to calculate a basic earning per share. Then how can you calculate basic earning per share? This is question to calculate basic earning per share. That is profit or loss attributable to ordinary equity shareholders of the parent entity. From the question, you can understand that here, after tax profit is 40 lakh, preference dividend is 5 lakh. Then profit or loss attributable to ordinary equity shareholders of the parent entity will be 35 lakh. Likewise, the weighted average number of ordinary shares outstanding in the period will be number of shares outstanding 1 lakh, 1 lakh into 12 by 12. That is 1 lakh. Then the final answer will be 35 lakh divided by 1 lakh. That is 35. Basic earning per share will be 35. Okay, then there's another question. Agas Limited reported a net earnings of 50 lakh for the financial year ending 2020-2021. The company had 2,50,000 shares of rupees 10 par value common stock and 1 lakh shares of rupees 80 par value convertible preference shares outstanding in the year. The dividend right on the preference shares was rupees 4 per share. Each share of the convertible preference shares can be converted into 2 shares of Agas Limited, Class A common shares. In the year, no convertible preference shares were converted. What will Agas Limited's basic EPS? How can you calculate? Use the same equation. Basic earning per share is equal to profit or loss attributable to ordinary equity shareholders of the parent entity. That means profit before tax, less preference dividend, less tax on preference dividend, less minority interest. That means in this question, basic EPS will be 50 lakh minus preference dividend. Preference dividend will be rupees 4 per share. That means 1 lakh into 4 per share. That is equal to 4 lakh. Then 50 lakh minus 4 lakh divided by number of shares outstanding is 2,50,000. 2,50,000 into 12 by 12. That is 2,50,000. Then the final answer will be 50 lakh minus 4 lakh. That is 46 lakh by 2,50,000. That is the answer will be 18.4. Okay, thank you.